So if you want to know how to change your images so they fit in with social media, so you get consistency that improves your branding, then this video is for you. There's your Facebook profile photo, there's your Google business profile cover photo, there's the size of your logo. Well, today I'm going to show you the easiest way you can resize all those images so that you get consistency, and it's for free. There's no login, there's no downloads. Now, you'll know from my other videos that you need to build your brand. You want brand consistency, and if you build your brand, it improves the strength of how you're perceived, not just by the search engines, but also by your local customers. But unless you're a web designer, that can be a real challenge, resizing images. There's lots of challenges because an image that looks great on YouTube or Google Business may not look ideal on Facebook or Instagram. Now, if you're new here, I just want to say that this channel uses my 22 years of experience as a web designer. So if you want to learn from my experience, then make sure you subscribe down below and I'll provide you with more tips going forward. So the tool I'm going to show you today is called Resizing App, and you can either use it within your Chrome browser or just through a web browser, or you can actually download it as a Chrome extension if you prefer. Now, the Chrome extension is quite small and I find it quite difficult to use, and also you may feel more comfortable not downloading a Chrome extension. Using the browser itself I found was really easy to use, and actually one of the challenges is just knowing how to crop, how to use it, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. Also, in a moment, I'll reveal all of the exact sizes you need to know for LinkedIn, Twitter, for Google My Business or Google Business Profile, for Facebook and for Instagram. You need to almost know exactly what's what to then be able to get them resized exactly to the most optimized value. And as a bonus, for those that watch right to the end of this video, I'm going to show you a trick to get Google to list all your social media accounts within your Google Business Profile. Now, most people don't know about this. I'm going to show you how to do that at the end of this video. The first thing you need to do is go to Google and type in resizing app, and you can, if you wanted to, add a Chrome extension. Whereas actually, if you go a bit further down without downloading anything at all in your browser, you can have a much larger area to work in. Then you just need to upload an image that you're going to use. So it might be your logo, it might be your branding. First, we need to know what actually is the size you're wanting to change this to. So you can look at the cover size of, say, in this case, Facebook is 851 by 315. So you can go to here and you can make a choice as to whether you want to do it by width or height. Maybe you want to customize it. When it comes to these cover sizes, go to the crop. And the reason why cropping is important is you can make sure what area is that you want. You can also make sure that you get the exact size and the ratio. And you'll notice that's quite small. And that's the standard size because we've got quite a high definition photo. Hold the shift key down. You can now scale and get the right ratio, but something like that gives us the whole image. In fact, we could even go almost to the whole image there. So there you go, that gives me the whole image, and all I then need to do is apply, and I can choose on how much I optimize it. So I recommend somewhere in the middle. You don't want to optimize it fully, but you won't notice any difference because it's really, really very good at bringing down the size of the file. You then need to just make sure that, you know, most will accept JPEG, most will accept PNG. There are the odd occasions where you might find you need a different format to that, but normally JPEG is a good standard to have. And then I'm going to save that. And that's it, it downloads, and that's now ready to upload as a cover photo. Let me just show you one more thing as well you need to know. So I'm back here on my image, and the other reason you might find this useful is if you go to crop again, but this time rather than worrying too much about the social media aspect of it, you may just want to focus on something in particular on the image. So for instance, as a web designer, I might want to just show that section of the image. Now, I'm not associated at all with this website, but just notice it's free, it's done for a browser, it doesn't download anything. It's completely safe, it says, and I have to say I can't see any issues at all. It converts images as well. If you need to do that, you can go from one format to the other, so it's another great way to convert images. So just to re-emphasize what some of the features are, it can resize images, it helps you to optimize them to make them so that they get a bit more cleaner and faster upload, which helps. You can convert from, say, JPEG to PNG. You can crop, so you just get the piece that you want, and it's safe, and you're not downloading anything as well. And that's why I think this is a really useful tool to bookmark. So we all know that branding grows when you get consistency amongst all your social media accounts. In fact, Google wants to build on that by listing your social media proofs or your accounts. But how can you get Google to list your social media accounts when there's no area for you to submit those URLs? Well, there's a couple of things you can do to encourage Google to list them straight away. And actually, I managed to get mine all listed within 24 hours using a couple of tricks that I reveal on this video. So meet me there and I'll show you how you can get your social media accounts to go straight into Google Business Profile.